Hi, welcome to the third module of Sustainable Packaging in a Circular Economy. This week, we will explore renewable and biodegradable packaging. Last week, Peter Rem already mentioned the use of renewable materials as alternatives to plastic. We will see that we can also use renewable sources to make plastic. After last week's case study with Coca-Cola, we asked you to share examples of other corporate visions in sustainable packaging. One example was about packaging in which products like clothes can be shipped to the customer. The products were packed in a special paper with integrated seeds. This way, the customer can use the paper to grow flowers while the paper dissolves in the soil. The vision of this company is to avoid waste and turn the packaging into a biological resource. If you haven't contributed to the discussion so far, please share an example and comment on the other learners' contributions. We've also seen insightful submissions to last week's assignment on Sketch Drive. Teresa, for example, analyzed a milk packaging. She looked at the different layers of cardboard, aluminium, and PE. She concluded that the amount of materials should be minimized and easy to separate during recycling. She suggests using cardboard that is made of recycled material or is FSC certified. The packaging also needs to contain information for consumers on how to dispose of it after use. It ultimately depends on the effort of the consumers as to how well a material will be separated before collection. Awareness about separation and collection are recurring themes in this episode, as we will look into renewable and biodegradable packaging.